So good afternoon, friends. I hope we have studied yesterday the basics of bus architecture. That is the overall of that. That is what we have studied, and we have started with that overall structure of 8085 microprocessor. Actually, it is a kit on which we are supposed to work. We are supposed to feed the programs, as well as we are supposed to execute the programs in 8085. So now in this section, we are actually trying to learn how a microprocessor communicates with other peripheral devices like memory, input output devices, and say the output side world. So this is where we were studying this. So for that, we have started with this. I have shown you this kit structure. Hopefully, since we are working online, so we won't be able to use this kit actually. But in in due course, when this shutdown will be over and offline classes will start, I hope you will be really happy to see this kit and work on this kit, because this kit is not going to be used in your whole life. In BSc Electronics itself, we are going to teach this microprocessor kit and programming of microprocessor, because this is a crucial section where the programming starts. So to learn any sort of programming, we require a basic of it, and microprocessor 8085 is the basic 8-bit microprocessor where we can perform the programs. So this was a wonderful device. So I have shown you this. I have shown you how to feed the program. Yesterday we have started with, I hope if you remember, that 8085 bus structure. Am I audible and my screen is visible to you all? Okay, thank you. You can chat it on chat box. Thank you. So yesterday we have studied the microprocessor unit, in which we have studied how a microprocessor, which is shown over here on the left hand side, 8085 MPU. Now it is going to communicate with the address bus. It is going to get the data or write the data in the memory, input and output devices to the real world, or say how this 8085 generates the control signals and controls all memory, input and output devices, and how it communicates, how it receives the data, how it takes the data, and how it writes the data in the memory itself. So that is what we have studied yesterday. And then this was the bus structure. Then this was something which really show how address bus and the data bus works. So here we are trying to tell you that 87 to 80 are multiplexed address, as well as the lower order address bus, as well as the data bus. So this data bus 80 87 is being controlled by this latch, which we call it as address latch enable, and it gives you again the A0 A7 address line. When this is enabled, so it will, this lines are going to work as address lines, and when this latch is disabled, it is going to work as a data line. So this is the blue colored bus D0 to D7. So this is the main feature of that address latch enable, as well as the address. Then we are having A8 to A15. Now again, in the further diagram, if you are able to see that they are again being divided into two portions, A8 to A15. The upper one is A10 to A15, means these five lines are being used to select the chip. Means there are various chips, slots of microprocessor, the memories in over there, and these are being selected by using this upper 4-bit. And the lower A0 to A9, these 10 lines are directly giving you the address of that particular chip. So we might be having, say, 6 to 7 chips likewise, and we are going to select this by using this A10 to A15, and these lines are common, so we are going to move those lines, give those lines to all those chips, and at particular location in that chip we are going to use the data, or we are going to write the data. So this is how these address and data lines are working in unison with the control signals generated by 8085. Then we have some more control signals like read memory bar, read bar, write bar, input output oblique memory bar. Now, whether the instruction is related to memory or the input output devices, the input output oblique memory bar signal or the wire or that line takes care of this signal. So this is control generated by that timing and control unit. Now the second one is whether the data is to be read from the memory or write to the memory, so that those signals are being taken care of by these two lines which are over here, read bar and write bar. As you know that these two lines are having a complement, which implies that they are active low. So these signals, active low signals, are being used over there. So read bar and write bar, they are going to say that memory. So depending on that, the memory is going, the data is being read or data is being write on the in the memory location. So this is how it goes. So when we were talking in terms of, say, the memory location, say to move the data from the accumulator to the memory, which means that we have to write the data from the accumulator or copy the data from the accumulator to the memory location. So that is done by this control signals, which we call it as the read and write bar signals. Now they are going to control whether the data is to be written on the in the memory or whether the data is to be read from the memory. So when we have put the data, first data in the memory, that was say 04 in the memory location 6050, then the data is to be read from there. So that is taken by the read bar signal. And when we are putting the result in that memory location, the signal write bar comes into play. So this is how it is being controlled by the 8085, depending on the instruction decoder set or decoder block, which is going to decode that instruction, and a particular signal is being generated by the timing and control unit. This is going to be controlled by the 8085 microprocessor and timing and control unit. So this was there. Then this was the MPU microprocessor unit communication and bus timing diagram. So this is how we'll be working on this when we'll be studying the instruction sets. So this is how it is generating the signals. So say these are the registers B, C, D, E and HL. These are stack pointer, program counter, and this is the address bus. So this is all there. When I say the moving the data from memory A to C, the machine code that is generated is 4FH. So 4FH is actually 0100 and F means 111. So this is the opcode that we are going to use. And this opcode, which is written over there at in the memory location 2005, is being taken by the address, shown by the program counter. And this 4F is being taken by the data bus, and then it is put to the data internal data bus. Now, whether this data is to be fed to the register C. So when I say that this register C is to be loaded with this 4F. So this data is being decoded by this instruction decoder, and the control logic which is generated will give the read bar signal as low. That implies that we have to read the data from the memory location 2005. So this is how it goes. Whenever we are executing or whenever we are writing an instruction, there are some internal functions which are being operated inside the microprocessor unit, which instruct the other devices how the device is to work, whether it is to write the program or whether it is to read the program from them. Now, in this case, when this program counter is specifying that we are having the opcode, that is 4F at 2005, then what happens? The program counter will give you that address, that is 2005, it is going to tell you that the data is there in 2005. Now 4F is supposed to be the data. This 4F data is taken by the address, the data bus to the internal data bus. Now this is going to be given by the read control, which implies that we have to read the data from the memory location. So everything is planned over there, and they are being using like this. So this data is now being given to the instruction decoder register. This instruction, since it is an opcode, is being decoded by this instruction registers, and accordingly the data is being generated. Now, so now the opcode is 4F, which implies that we have to move the data, we have to move the data from register A to the register C, which implies that it is going to copy the data from the accumulator to register C. So this opcode will now generate or make a control signal, which is going to show that the data is to be transferred from the accumulator to register C. So the data is to be read from the accumulator, and then it is put on the internal data bus, then it goes to the register combinations, then it will specifically go to register C. So the data is moving from the accumulator to the register C. Actually, it is not moving, but it is actually copying the data. So the data is to be copied from the accumulator to the register C. And at both the places, the data is stored. There, the data is intact. So data is not being moved, but it is being just copied from the accumulator to the register C. So that is being done by this instruction. This is how it performs internally, and it communicates with the memory as well as the registers and the internal blocks of the 8085 microprocessor unit. So this is how it's going to work. Now coming to the next part of this, that is the basic and the important part of the microprocessor unit, which we have started a little bit, and that is the instruction set. So now we will be working on how the what are the types of the instructions that we are going to use. So broadly, these instructions are classified into two types. That is based on word size. Word size means how many byte it requires to have or to execute that particular instruction. So that is called as a word size. So word size, the data can be one word, that is the opcode only. So that those instructions are a single byte instruction. So for example, like CMA, this is the complement of the accumulator. So CMA tends for to complement the data of the accumulator. Now, since we have to just complement the data, we will require only the opcode. So the data is already stored in the register A. We have to just complement it. So that is that instruction CMA. The other instruction can be A add B. And we have used add C, add D, add M. So these are one byte instruction, which implies that there is only 8-bit or two-digit hexadecimal code is there. So we have used add M also. So that is one of the instruction. So these instructions are called as one word or a single byte instructions. So this is one byte, one word, opcode only. Now the second type is two word, or we will have two data. One will be the opcode and the other one will be the data. So we'll require two memory locations or a two byte instruction, 2 8-bit instruction. That is one opcode, operational code, and the other one is the actual data. So that we can call it as a two word opcode and an operand. So for example, we have used this MVIA32H, which implies that we are using that MVIA32. So we will have two codes which are generated by which are having two opcodes. The first one is the opcode and the other one is the data. So that is how we have written a program in over there, that MVIA03 we have loaded. So in that we have used a two byte instruction. The one was the opcode. What opcode we have used? 3E. So for MVIA, 3 is the opcode, and the next coming will be the data. So here in this instruction, we have used MVIA32H. H stands for the hexadecimal number. So 32 is not a decimal number, but it is a hexadecimal number. Even the opcodes are in hexadecimal code. So MVIA, now the instruction will be 3E32. So 32 will be the data and 3E will be the opcode. So how many bytes we have required? We have required 2 byte or 2 word opcode. So the first one is the opcode and the second one is the operand or the data. Now the 3 word opcode that we have also used, that was the opcode and 2 datas. So that is 3 byte instruction. We call it as a 3 byte instruction or a 3 word opcode. So 3 word opcode has 1 opcode and 2 byte data. So we are having this. So we have used that instruction as LXIHL. So load immediately the HL pair by the data, right? We have used that. So what was the opcode of it? That was 21. And what was the data we have substituted? 6050. So first we have put the initial address, that was 50. And the second one was the higher order, that is 60. So we were having that. Right. So this is the another instruction, that is LDA4200. LDA means load the accumulator directly from the memory location 4200. Or second instruction is store accumulator directly to the memory location 4500. So these are 3 byte instructions. One will be the opcode and the other will be 2 byte data, that is 4200. So while writing, we have to write the opcode, then the lower address of the memory location and the higher address. So we'll be writing like this. LDA, can anybody tell me what is the opcode for LDA? I've substituted you with that list. So if those lists are there with you, so I request you to kindly go through that list and let me know what is the load LDA the opcode of the LDA instruction. Anybody can unmute themselves and tell me what is LDA, opcode of LDA. Yes, is there anybody, or I have to go through that instruction set, right? So LDA is okay
16 bit.
अरे बेटा 16 बिट नहीं है, उसके जस्ट पहले का 3A. यस, सो 3A इज द ऑपकोड एंड देन वी हैव टू गिव अ 16 बिट मींस 2 बाइट द एड्रेस, राइट? सो LDA 420 वी विल राइट लाइक दिस. LDA इज व्हाट वाज इट, LDA इज यस 3A, दैट दिस इज द ऑपकोड, एंड देन वी विल राइट 00 एंड देन वी विल राइट 42. So we'll be using 3 bytes, 3 memory location for that. 3A, that is the opcode, and then we'll be using the memory address, location of the address. So that is, now in this case we have used 4200, that is we will be using first 00, then we'll be using 42. So we'll be giving that address. Similarly for STA 4500, which implies that we can directly store the data of the accumulator, store the accumulator directly to the memory location specified by this. So STA ka instruction hai 32. So 32 is the opcode of that, then we have to put it in 4500, which implies that we'll be using 320045. So it is a 3 byte instruction. So this is how this is specified in word size. So हम लोग इसको दो इसमें भागों में डिवाइड कर सकते हैं. Now second the group जो है, second type जो है, that is on depending on the function. Now, which type of function the instruction is having? So the first one is the data transfer group. Means what is it? We have divided this on the sort of function into five categories. The first one is the data transfer group, which implies that we have to just move the data, copy the data. Now remember this word, punchline of this, that while moving the data, no flags are being affected. Flags are only affected when we are having arithmetical and logical operations operating or executing on it. So, right? So the first group that we are having is a data transfer group, which implies that we have to just move the data from one, say, register to memory, or say from register to register, or from say anywhere from the other outside world to the register, anywhere. So we are just copying the data from one place to the another. That is why it is called as the move, copying the data. So that is the group, data transfer group. So this is there. The instruction is move B to A. The first instruction, if we have view over here, so that is the first one is move B to A. So that the content of the register B is being copied or moved to register A. This is, then the second one is MVI A32H. This is what we have already used it. So I don't need to tell that. Then we are having the next instruction as move 4500 to C. So whether this is going to work? No, I hope this is not an instruction. So we can't move this data to register C. We can move what? We will have to use an instruction like MVI C45. So this is not an instruction. Remember this. This is wrongly written over here. Move C. Move 4500 to C. It is not over there. So this instruction does not exist. What we have to use? MVI C45. So the 45 is directly moved to the register C. That is there. Now the second group is the arithmetic operation group. So the arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, increment and decrement, they all come in the addition group. So we are using this add B, subtract with borrow immediately 32H. Aisa hai ye. Iska pura jo SBI 32 jo hai, ye instruction ka kya matlab hota hai? Subtract immediately the content of the data or the data with the accumulator with borrow SBI. Theek hai, hum log jab usko padhenge depth mein tab aapko main usko acche se bataunga. So this is one of the example. INCD. So for just to increase the data of one of the register, so we are using increment. INCD means the count or the data of the register D can be incremented by one. And for to increase the data of register pair, we have to use INXH, X. So whenever there are X, it implies that it is related to the register pair. So this is for INCD, means increment the content of the data register D by one. And the second one is decrement B, means the content of register B is to be decremented by one. So this is there. Then we have logical operations like ANAB. So and the content of register A with register B, this is there. Then we have OR I, mean immediately this data is to be ORed with the content of accumulator. And RLC RAR, so rotate the content of accumulator left with carry, rotate the accumulator content of accumulator right. So these are RLC and RAR. We'll be studying these are in depth. Okay, we have only 5 minutes to go, right? So this is over there.
Sir, math.
Haan, beta?
Sir, math class.
Okay. So I will just stop this. I will take your attendance and I will end the class. Thank you. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye.